Welcome to Woodlawn this morning. How many are glad to be in the house of God? Would you stand all across the building? Would you put your hands together and welcome the presence of the Lord into this place? God, we invite you in. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for this opportunity to lift you up and to magnify you. If you're ready to receive something in the house today, would you clap your hands and would you worship with us this morning? Your glory, we want your power, we want your spirit on display in this house. That's our prayer this morning, that heaven would come down to earth and meet us. God, we thank you this morning. We thank you. Amen. Welcome to Woodlawn this morning. You have made an incredible decision to be here. This is a great place. Why is it a great place? Because each week, people's lives are literally being changed by the power of Jesus Christ. And today, we have another person that's about to go down in the waters of baptism. If you would direct your attention to Pastor Jared.
Praise the Lord, everyone. It is so good to be here today. And I am so glad to be joined today by Jenny Claire Weeks. This is Scott Weeks' daughter. And Jenna Lynn McKenzie is Scott's fiance. And that is how the Weeks family has been coming to Woodlawn. And 2 weeks ago, she decided it was time for her to be baptized, calling upon the name of Jesus. And we just give God praise for that. Amen. Amen. Just a funny story about Jenny Claire. It was on Friends Day in 2021, the first time I met her. And I was on the front porch just greeting our guest. And so I got to meet Jenny Claire for the first time, and I went to shake her hand, and she goes, "Oh no, I'm a hugger, let's hug." And so every time I see her now, I'm like, "I'm a hugger, let's hug." Guess what? Jesus Christ is hugging her today by his power, by his presence. Amen. Would you just help me pray for her right now all across this house? God, I thank you so much for what you're doing in this young lady's life. God, you are going to order her steps. God, you're going to do great things through her. God, for your church, for your kingdom, God. I thank you. Today is just the beginning, God, of an incredible journey, God, that she is on. I thank you for her family today, God, those that are here to support her. God, I just give you praise today, God. You deserve all of the glory. We don't get any credit for it, God. We give it all back to you today. In Jesus' name, amen. Jenny Claire, according to the word of God, in obedience to the Acts of the Apostles, I baptize you today in the only saving name, the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins.
Come on, do you remember that day that you took on that name in baptism? Come on, one more time, will we just thank him all across the house? God, we thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for your name that is above every name. God, we thank you. I got some good news. I think at the end of service today, we've got another one that's going to be baptized in Jesus' name. Amen. And if you have yet to take this step, you've yet to repent and be baptized in Jesus' name, the only saving name, today could be your day too, amen? God bless you. You can return to your seats. You can be seated this morning. I know I've already said it, but we welcome you to Woodlawn today. We are honored that you are here. If you are a guest that has joined us to worship today, Woodlawn family, could we give it up for all of our guests that are in the house today? Also, if you're watching online on Facebook or YouTube, we say welcome to you this morning. We pray blessings on you. If you have a prayer need, you can type it out in the chat, and we will pray with you about that need. If you are here in the auditorium, you have a prayer need in the seat back in front of you. There's a card, looks just like the one that I'm holding. On one side, it says prayer request, and you can fill that card out and either leave it in the seat back in front of you or drop it off in one of our give boxes in the back of the auditorium. And we will pray with you about that need this week. We have a lot of exciting things that are happening around here. It seems like our church, it's from one thing, one event, to the next, we're always moving, things are always taking place. But this Saturday is one of my most favorite things that we do here at Woodlawn. And that is at Saturday at 9 a.m., is our monthly First Saturday family prayer. Family prayer. If you haven't given your family the opportunity to come and pray with us here at Woodlawn on First Saturday prayer, you are missing out. I promise you, me and Pastor say it, and I'm not just saying it as a cliche statement, but I believe it. It is one of the best things that we do here at this church. And so I'm inviting you and your family, join us this Saturday for First Saturday family prayer, 9 a.m. You will not regret it. Another thing that is very exciting that is happening today is the launch, the kickoff of another semester of community groups. How many people love community groups? Woo! Today at 2 o'clock, we will open up all of our groups where you will have an opportunity to join a group. So what are community groups? Well, number one, it's a biblical thing. We are a Book of Acts church, and just as Acts chapter 2 declares, you know, we must repent, be baptized, receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. In that same chapter, the Bible declares that they went house to house, breaking bread, spending time with one another, and God added to the church daily. And so the reason we believe in small groups, or what we call community groups here at Woodlawn, is not just because we want to add another thing to the calendar, but we believe that it is a biblical model for God's people to come together, do life together, and grow in their faith. And so we have over 40 groups this semester, and that's incredible, over 40 groups. But I am certain that of those 40, there is a group for you. We have prayer groups. We have a group that's going to center around doing some art. We have a group that is going to go hang out, play basketball. But every group that there is will be centered around a spiritual component, will be centered around a prayer moment, and will be centered around you growing in your faith with other believers. And so if you've never been a part of community groups, I am just challenging you. Take a step. Maybe you were like, man, I've just been here at Woodlawn a short period of time. I really don't know anybody. This is your way to get connected on a deeper level and begin to develop relationships that will strengthen your life. We are better together. And so today at 2 o'clock, we will open these groups. What we're going to do for you, we're going to send a church-wide text as a reminder at 2 o'clock. Behind me, there's instructions. If you are not a part of our text group, pull out your phone right now real quickly. Get your phone out, and you can text the number 81010, and in the text portion, all you need to send is the @WCText. Click send, and now you will begin to start receiving our Woodlawn Church text messages. And that's very important, because today at 2, you're going to be sent a link where you can click that link and you can join a group. You can also join on the Church Center app. I feel like anytime I have a microphone in my hand at this church, I'm talking about that app. But it is such a great tool, such a great resource for you, and it's so easy. Literally at the bottom of that app, you can click groups and then click community groups, and it will open you up today at 2 o'clock to a catalog of groups that you can check out. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and say this. Don't be doing it during the message today, but maybe while you're having lunch, go check out the groups today, because I'm just going to be honest with you. There are some people, they're waiting at 2 o'clock, and at 2 o'clock, they're going to join a group immediately. And so if you see a group you want to be a part of, make sure you are ready at 2 o'clock and you're clicking through and joining that group. It is going to be an amazing semester. We meet about 6 times through the course of the next 3 months, and I know your life will be enriched by you taking this step. How many are excited for another semester of community groups? It's going to be amazing. It's going to be amazing. And so 2 o'clock today, it all starts. Let me just remind you here of a few ways that you can continue to be a giver at this church. The first way is on our website, woodlawnchurch.cc. Another way is right here in the worship center, our give boxes. And then the world famous Church Center app is another way that you can give. And then, of course, you can give via text message. The number and instructions are behind me. They're on the screen there. But just as a reminder, last week we took a Move the Mission offering, and you responded in such a great way. Pastor will share that with you in a moment, but if you need to give to that, again, you can do it right on the app. You can put an envelope that you received last week into the give box in the back of the worship center. And we're just grateful, and we are blessed at this church because of givers like you. Amen. Would you stand to your feet one more time? Each week here at this church, we do an offering declaration. We don't do it to just take up time, but we believe in declaring God's promises over our family, over our finances. So will you join with me this morning? Upon the authority and by the orders of your word, I have given, and it shall be given to me, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. I bring my tithe and offering to you. Therefore, the enemy is rebuked and the curse is broken. I receive your blessings and the abundance that comes with them. I receive jobs and promotions, raises and bonuses, sales and commissions, benefits and settlements, bills paid off and debts dismissed. I decree that my whole family will be saved and walk with God in health, abundance, and in divine favor and blessings. I shall be blessed going in, I shall be blessed going out, and all that I do will prosper in Jesus' name. Amen. And it is so. Would you lift your voice to the Lord and thank Him right now?
Hey, before you're seated, why don't you just step across the aisle, turn around, tell somebody it's good to see them today in the house of the Lord. Wonderful looking congregation here today. When you're done doing that, you can be seated today. Pastor Cliff just mentioned about our Move the Mission offering, which we took last Sunday during service. And Pastor Logan did such a great job in casting vision for Move the Mission. Last year, this church gave $45,000 to Move the Mission. And then Pastor Logan gave you a goal last week of $50,000. I am happy to report to you that this church, you, pledged and gave over $80,000 last week. Can we give God glory for that? We didn't do it, He did. He's blessed us abundantly, and we give Him praise. Thank you for your heart for giving. We say all the time, we are a river, not a reservoir. The blessings of the Lord flow through here, and I promise you, every cent that you give to Move the Mission will go to further the gospel around the world. This past Wednesday night, my wife and I finished a You Belong Here graduation, and at this time, I want those that completed You Belong Here to run out of your seat real quick and join me here at the altar space real quick. And Woodlawn, while they're coming, why don't you just give them a hand right now? I didn't put any pressure on them. I said, if you don't want to walk in front of this beautiful crowd, we understand. But you see them coming right now. We graduated 31 brand new people this past week. Awesome. Is this beautiful or what? They're still coming out of the balcony today. And if you have never been through You Belong Here, listen to me. Whether you are a member, you are a guest, or you've been coming and you just haven't plugged in, You Belong Here is a place for you to find out who we are as a church. It's also a place for you to find out who you are as a person and how God has wired you and gifted you to bless His kingdom. Then you'll also find out how, if you'll plug into this church, we believe you'll love it here, but more than that, you'll grow in your relationship with God. All of these people invested 3 weeks of their lives. And we don't have a new members class or a new member way, but You Belong Here is our way to say, hey, if you want to be a part of our home, come through You Belong Here, and we welcome you to be a part of Woodlawn. And so I want, hold on. I want us to give this group before me a warm Woodlawn thanks and a warm Woodlawn welcome to every person that completed You Belong Here. Can you help me, Woodlawn, right now celebrate these? Is this awesome or what? Man, thank you guys so much. Looking forward to growing with you. You can be seated right now. And if you're interested in signing up for You Belong Here, there is a card in the seat back in front of you. Check the box. Sign me up. You can slip it right back in that seat back, or you can drop it in the give boxes as you leave today. Anybody ready to worship? That wasn't convincing. Anybody ready to worship today? Come on now, let's give God praise. Right where you're seated, can you lift your hands? Heavenly Father, I thank you for what you're about to do in this place. God, for the next hour, Lord, I pray that your spirit would just absolutely cover this place. Let a cloud of your presence, God, be in the atmosphere today. God, I thank you for what you're about to do. And I pray that you would get all of the praise, the honor, and the glory today in Jesus' name. Can everybody say amen?
Yeah. another glimpse of glory. We'll see you once more. Worthy, 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 Lord. Worthy, 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 Lord. Another glimpse of glory. We'll see you once more. Worthy, 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 Lord. Forever.
hand lifted, would we declare that?
You are holy, oh so holy. You are holy, Lord of all. You are holy, oh so holy.
Prophet Isaiah that said, woe is me. I feel that same spirit in here today, that when we look at who we are, what we've done in comparison to how great our God is. I just want to fall on my knees and say, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Do I have anybody here today that would lift your hands with me and just declare how holy he is in the house? Spirit today, would you declare how holy he is? We've come on this Sunday to pause our lives, to say, God, I am nothing without you. I cannot make it without you, oh God. Your presence is everything to me, oh God. God, we thank you for your spirit that is here right now. I thank you for the season this church is in, the harvest, oh God, that you have for us, miracles, signs, and wonders. You have called this church to prayer, God, and there are prayer groups going on constantly around this sanctuary, around this building, and across the Pine Belt, oh God. I thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. God, I pray for miracles, signs, and wonders, not to be something out of the ordinary, God, that it would be a common everyday occurrence in this house. Let us be prepared for the harvest that you have in these last days, oh God. We stand here today, God, and I stand here as pastor of this wonderful church to just declare to you, I cannot do this without you. This is your church. This is not my church, oh God. This is your kingdom. This is not our kingdom. God, we just want to be a part of your harvest in these last days, because you will have a church. There will be worshipers. There will be those that praise. Your word says if we don't, the rocks will cry out. But God, I stand among friends today to say, hey, there's no rock going to take my place. I'm going to declare the goodness of our God today. So one more time, would you give him a hand clap today and give him just a standing ovation of praise? He's worthy of it. He's worthy of it. Amen. Remain standing today. It is always a great honor to have our guest that is with us. Brother Morton Bustard has visited this church for 30 years in a row, except last year. He was scheduled to come last year when one of the hurricanes had moved through South Louisiana. And I called him and I said, I don't feel good about you getting on the road. And he did not come that weekend. I preached. But he's been a blessing to this church. He's been a blessing to our family. He was one of the best friends of our bishop. And I am so thankful for the friendship that I now share with him. He's anointed of God. He preaches somewhere different every single week. He is used in the prophetic. But more than that, he is an evangelist and a preacher of the word. And I am so glad to have him at Woodlawn today. Can we one more time give Brother Morton Bustard a warm Woodlawn welcome as he comes to preach to us today.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Let's give the Lord a big hand clap of praise. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. My first time to minister here without Tommy Wallace and Bishop James Carney. If you'll indulge me just for about 2 minutes. Dear men, I pulled into town 35 years ago, 87. Datha was here. Kayla wasn't even a thought. Getting my evangelistic legs under me. This spot became special from the first trip. I miss James Carney. I miss Tommy Wallace. Brother Carney did not stand only on his hill. At least one situation, Brother Carney let me know that he would have my back. So Marilyn and I pay tribute to these men, to Bishop Carney. I miss him dearly. Sister Jean Carney, we love you with all our hearts, and we're believing that God has a word for you today. And Pastor Jaron, you and Sister Holly, destined to be together. I remember the first time I saw her. It was a weekend when I came. The two of you were dating. And there was a meal being prepared at the Carney Ponderosa, which was not uncommon. Those were the days when Sister Jean Carney's mother would say, "You're learning to preach." And I loved it. But the two of you have an amazing family. Was that your daughter over here you were standing beside? When you were worshiping over here? Okay. Where are you pointing to her? That was her singing. You have an amazing family. You have an amazing family. You are a wealthy man. And you're not here because of default or nepotism. God has placed you here. Are the house lights all the way up? If not, would you bring them up? Because it's not the best combination to have a prophetic anointing and beady eyes. So light really helps out. Amen. Marilyn sends her greetings. She's doing amazingly. Yesterday we had a birthday party for our youngest grandson, Jack, who just turned 2. And then September 20, we'll have a 5-year birthday party for George and Jack. Right here. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it. I'm Pops, she's Lolly, Lolly Pops. George says, "Pops, whenever you go away, I think about you all the time." Amen. Privileged to be here. God bless you. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 12 down through verse 17. Man, you got the sound. Boom. I don't know what's going on in the atmosphere, but it tries to mess with my vocal cords. But I know this team is so good, you're going to help me through it. This crowd might get loud. If they do, don't turn them down. Just turn me up. Amen. Are you here for a good time today? Isaiah chapter 14, verse 12, reading on down through 17. "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which did weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High." I. Verse 15, yet, say yet. "Thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee." When you see him, you're not going to go, "Wow." You're going to go, "What?" And consider thee, saying, you're going to think about it and say, "Is this the man that made the earth to tremble, that did shake kingdoms, that made the world as a wilderness and destroyed the cities thereof, that opened not the house of the prisoners?" Would you say my text with me? Overreach. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray for signs, wonders, and miracles. Many people to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost today. Lord Jesus, we give you all the praise and the glory. Would you lay that Bible down and take at least 30 seconds to give him a thunderous round of applause? praise him. An observation. I weighed 125 when I came here 35 years ago. I weigh about 127 now. I have just gotten uber strong. I pick up these bottles and as if they're just made a little bit weaker, but I think it's me getting stronger. They just feel so. We're going to be genteel with this today. We got this broadcasting around the world. Are you going to help me? You may be seated. So March 2020, everything just changed. We went to bed one night and awakened to a completely changed world. I had my suspicions. Discerning of spirits was also truly, discerning of spirits was playing a role in how I was feeling right in here. And then we were told, just give us 14 days. 14 days. Now, it's going to cramp your style, but we'll try not to, to enforce and impose too many recommendations and so forth. And I'm glad we're on day 13 because I can't wait for one more day to get this behind me. Well, it was elongated. It was not brief. It went all the way through 2020. And some of you were told we're not essential. Interesting. That went all the way through 2020 and then 2021. And guess what? We still see some, reflections of it every now and again in 2022. And then we find out that there truly is a WEF, there truly is a dude named Klaus Schwab, and they truly have an agenda. Those are facts. And just when we were catching our breath because someone said the pandemic has become an endemic, and praise God for that, and then the person had to retract that because someone got to him, we had this other little thing called the war in the Ukraine. No matter what you think about the Ukraine government, whether it's a money laundering government, whatever, the fact of the matter is those precious souls in the Ukraine do not deserve any of the living hell that they're enduring. Boy, you're going to be fun to preach to today. There's so much liberty here today. I got to make sure I don't overtake, just take too much liberty. But don't worry, the next 3 hours will feel like 35 minutes. Well, there are three kind of people in this world, those who can count and those who can't. And then we have this thing called inflation, and I don't know the availability of baby formula. Thank God gas is $3.49. I like it at $1.87 myself. And I'm hard-headed, but at least I have scripture because I'll paraphrase a passage in the Old Testament. He made his prophets' heads hard. How hard is my head? You want to know? When I was here and 6 months old, my father accidentally ran over me with his 59 Pontiac, and it went over my head. 18 days in the hospital observation, no problems. Yep. Would have been a good time to have that technology of the backup camera. Automatic brakes. The alarm, beep, beep, but I wouldn't have this testimony. I don't like being told I'm not essential. I don't like being told what to do. I do believe in bodily autonomy. I do believe in the Bill of Rights. I do believe in asking questions. I do believe in another opinion. And I don't believe that man is God. And I'm not taking kindly to the day when they're going to try to force me to eat a filet mignon that's been created in a 3D printer that came from a microbe. Now, I'm going to be straight with you. I love beef. I like all the food groups. Modesty and everything, just Bring it on. Maryland will tell you this is the truth. Driving through fields once in a while, we'll see some cattle grazing, big old black Angus certified, everything. I just simply say, man, it's good to see you. Let's have dinner one day. That is the truth. And someone is taking advantage of these situations, and they're pushing their agenda, and they're pushing you and I because we're middle class. Nothing is going to change for the uber wealthy because nothing did change. They still snuck out to their restaurants, the French Laundry. I didn't even get to go to the Irish Cleaners. That's original. That's, I don't care who you are, that's funny. And nothing's going to change for them. So here you are, you're wondering, how far is this going to go? Is it going to keep drifting or going down the slope until we are forced into something? And I mean, how powerful. Now, please note, he is mentioned by name in our text, but I'm not going to call him by his name. I'm going to try not to. But when I refer to God, I'm going to talk about him. But when I refer to the enemy, I'm going to talk about him, because he's down there. He's not up there. He has fallen and he can't get up. But how far is this going to go? And has he now gained full control? He must be a mastermind. I think that in 40 years of preaching, I may have used that term, mastermind. He's, you know, whatever. But then again, I don't think he is. I do not believe he's the brightest light burning or the sharpest knife in the drawer. I really don't, because he was there. You and I have had wonderful experiences. We have had heavenly experiences, but not in heaven. We have been redeemed, but we're not raptured. But I promise you, when you're raptured, you will agree with the scripture, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of the saints. Because Tommy and the bishop, they love you, but they're on the other side of the Jordan, and they're not coming back. I promise you, one moment in his presence is going to blow your mind, because here's the deal. Please keep the sound up. Here's the deal, ladies and gentlemen. You and I can have experiences that are ethereal and supernatural, but we cannot stand or handle the undiluted, raw glory of God, because no flesh can see him and live. And I understand the context of that, but I'm going to tell you something. Your terrestrial body would not last 1/1000th of a nanosecond if you were exposed to the raw glory of God Almighty. You would be better to take a chance living 5 minutes on the solar surface of that big old ball called the sun than you would to be to stand in a celestial body, in a terrestrial body, in the presence of God. No matter how great experience you have, you still have not experienced the raw glory of God. But he did. Did. And he said, I'm going higher. I'm going to go to the top of the sides of the north. I'm going to rise above the clouds. I am going to be like the Most High. Brothers and sisters, after 40 years of preaching the gospel around the world and witnessing wonderful miracles, and a gentleman by the name of Robert Costa. Robert is a preacher, he's an entrepreneur, he's an accountant, he's in the Michigan area. About 2, maybe 3 months ago, he sent me a text. He said, Brother Bustard, I'm having lunch with a man right now who said 25 years ago or so in Oconomowoc, Wisconsin, his little boy was born with one lung. You prayed and said, everything's going to be all right. They took him to the hospital. He miraculously got another lung, and after 25 years, those lungs are working perfectly. Several years ago in the Chicago area, a young lady, full-blown AIDS, was completely healed from HIV positive. Isn't that absolutely amazing? But brothers and sisters, I have never one time said, hey, Jesus, if you don't want to go to Woodlawn today, I'll handle it. If you need to rest up, I will handle this. I have never, ever, ever thought that. But he did. And God said, you can't go any higher. I let you experience this. I allowed you to be part of that worship. I let you. And now you're drawing a third of the stars with you. Mm-mm. I am God, and beside me there is no other. I have no rival, no equal, no opposite. There is none before me, none beside me, no one after. Promotion does not come from the left or to the right. I set up and I take down. Get out of my heaven. And you are never, ever coming anywhere near this place. From this moment, you are not experiencing any ascent, only descent. You will never rise even so much as an inch. You will go down, down, down until you reach the sides of the pit, but you will never rise back up. But I will tell you what I will do. I will allow those who you tempt and influence, I will give them a door. I will give them a staircase. I will let them ascend. They will come up and they will come back into my presence. And that's the reason why the enemy loathes you. He despises you. Because once again, you put in a hard week. Once again, you had to elbow your way through test, temptation, persecution, and high gas prices and high food prices. And you came. Even though gasoline is near and dear, you came. You burned that gas by burning your paycheck to get in here, and you brought the tithe and offering, and you did not do it with a heavy heart. You did it cheerfully. And when you came, you did not bring what you had on reserve. You brought your best praise. Praise that your favorite team doesn't get. Praise that even your own husband or wife doesn't get. You praised him and you continue to do so. You anger him because you're back in his presence. You're not up there, but you're in the presence of the Almighty, and you're saying, holy, holy, holy. And he hates it because he can never, ever, ever get back into it. And I cannot refer to 2021 because a storm negated us coming. Your pastor was very kind anyhow. He made sure that that was not a dry weekend. Thank you. But since I was here in 2020, preached on the Unstoppable Church, and your bishop and I prayed right here, you have changed. If you were here in 2020, you're here in 2022. If this church was here in 2020, you're up here in 2022. You better get ready because you're going higher. You're going to go from glory to glory. The glory of God is going to carry you. Your hunger for God is going to increase. It will not be burdensome, no matter what happened in your week, to come into the house of the Lord and bring your praise. And you ought to see who's waiting in the wings to come in here. You ought to see those who have been trampled by the enemy and put way, way down. God's going to raise them up. So he overreached. So he overreached. But then he reached again in a place called Eden, in a garden, the woman. He said exactly what God said, except he put a little three-letter word in there. God said, thou shalt surely die. He said, thou shalt not surely die. Be careful, have truths or 90% truths. It's got to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Get into the Word of God. Don't let your favorite radio talk show host be the one who guides your life. Do not let your favorite news anchor or influencer be the one who guides your life. You gotta get the Word of God in your life. If you really want to gift your children something amazing, don't just give them an app for the King James Version of the Bible or whatever version. Get them the hardback. The hard copy. Get one with that India paper. Get one that you can actually move the papers and you will remember which side of that book in the chapter that verse is written. You got to get the Word of God in you because it's a crazy time we're living in. He said, here, take and eat. But the man wasn't missing. He was there. He just didn't say anything. You know what's happening right now? Men are present, but they're reticent. And evil is prevailing. Because they did it subtly. Many years ago, David Mamet, M-A-M-E-T, a Hollywood playwright, wrote the book, The Secret Knowledge, and he told us about Hollywood's agenda. That was years ago. It's being lived out. They get into your subconscious. First of all, they entice you with their lifestyle, the lifestyles of the rich and famous. And that kind of opens our intrigue. It piques our interest. And then they begin to manifest their lifestyles until all of a sudden we begin to accept it and we find ourselves in the end of August of 2022 and they are trying to give 6-year-olds and 3-year-olds blockers and chemicals that will change their lives forever, and they will never recover from it. And if children are not our hill that we're willing to perish on as a nation, we're irredeemable. Thank you for your school. Give the Lord a hand clap. The man could have said, get out of my garden. But they have taught us about toxic masculinity. And they have emasculated the man until, I'm just going to throw it down. Young lady, you wait for God to bring you a man of God. And to you, young lady, he will be a velvet-covered brick. He will be soft to the touch. He will understand your needs and your desires and so forth. But at the same time, don't mess with him because he's rock solid. He doesn't have a wishbone. He has a backbone. He takes a stand, and he will be your knight in shining armor. And if he has to, he will get in front of a bullet for you. That's who you're looking for. You know the story, and the Lord said, I'm going to put enmity between your seed and the seed of the woman. And you will bruise the heel of the seed, but hold your foot up. 3 seconds. Hold your foot up, and you're going to stomp it with me. But the seed shall, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Boom. The seed shall bruise your head. And then we go to another garden. If it's possible, let this cup pass from me. And then we go to a whipping post, and then we go to Calvary. And then, shortly after the crucifixion, something happened in the very bowels of the earth, inside the gates of hell. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to wrap it up and throw it down and do about 10 minutes of just freestyling. But before I do, ladies and gentlemen, the bruise is not a change in the pigmentation of the skin of his brow. He's been bruised. He never was real bright. If you're in heaven and you're exposed to the glory of God and you think, I can be like him, you're not right.
And now he's worse off than he ever was because he's not thinking right. Ladies and gentlemen, the anger in the world is what he is superimposing on humanity. But anger is rooted in fear. He is terribly afraid. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a creature who is afraid of his own creation because his fear has come on him and he knows he has a short time. Ladies and gentlemen, I got to tell you something about him. He has not increased since he was cast out of heaven. He will never increase in his power. He will never get more authority. I understand that hell has increased his borders because people are making bad decisions, but he is not increasing in his power and his dominion and authority. I know it's 2022, but he does not have any more authority since he did in January or February of 2020 before the pandemic, because he's a loser and he will never win and he will never lose. He has always overreached, and he's overreaching in your home right now. He's trying to tell you that your children are never going to come back to God. He is overreaching in your finances. He's overreaching in your health. He's trying to make a mockery out of your faith by saying, where is your Jehovah Rapha now? Where is your Jehovah Jireh now? Where is your Jehovah Shalom now in the midst of all the turmoil? I'll tell you where he is. He's right here. And he's Lord God Almighty. Musicians, get ready to come. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not going to end with the supply chain collapsing, until we could not get baby formula for the little ones. It is not going to end at $20 a gallon gasoline. The enemy always overreaches, and he's overreaching right now. And had the princes of this world known what was going to happen, they would never have crucified the Son of God, because he never wins and he never loses. He's messing with some of your minds right now. He's saying that child that is now part of an alternative lifestyle, they're never coming back. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you who cannot overreach. He cannot overreach because his arm is not short that it cannot save. I don't care where that child is, God's reach is going to get them. Doesn't matter how far that marriage has slipped down the slippery slope, God's reach is going to get it. Your marriage is about to get in the grasp of God's grace. God's about to turn everything around. You're not going to talk about an amicable agreement just to go your separate ways. It could be today that you just simply allow God to reach in and take that wedge out, and you're going to have a burning love for each other that you didn't have since the very first time you laid eyes on each other. Would you praise him in the house? Can I just have 5 more minutes? Let me prophesy to you. The first week of June, I flew to Vegas to preach, and as I was sitting there right before they gave me the platform, the pulpit, the Lord spoke to me and said, all of this perversion, child sex trafficking, everything that is going on right now, the Lord said, it has not just started in the last 5 or 10 years. The Lord said, it's been going on right under your noses, but you didn't see it. He's not behind COVID-19, but he's always been way out in front of it. And he can turn it around and say, I'm going to make a curse your blessing. Because God said, I'm going to do 2 things. Before I flush it, I'm going to flesh it. Before I flush that sewage out of society, I'm going to flesh it and bring it to the top. And America is going to smell the putrid odor and see clearly the filth, and she'll have to make a decision. So what happened in 2020 was parents were busy. She went to her job. He went to his job. They made money, 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 money. They were buying those big homes and everything. And they had no idea who was teaching their kids and what they were teaching them until they were walking through the living room and they saw the child doing online learning, and they stopped and their mouths just fell open, and they said, what are you teaching my kids? I am telling you right now, America's going to turn around. Bring up the sound. When your world is at its worst, your God is at his best. Don't write it off. Don't stop praying. The enemy knows he's losing. Just hang in there. Just hang in there, because God is good. He changes tides. And the pushback that the enemy is going to receive is going to be far greater than what he ever did. Would you stand with me all over the house? Musicians. Whatever you feel, you guys are amazing. You guys get your ears buds in and get in sync, and you just begin softly, and you hit the right one. I'll turn around and let you guys just run with it. I got to tell you something. I'm not going to pass you, but can I talk to you for 3 minutes? Can I talk to you? The Bible said they that seek him will find him as dew. You don't find dew in the middle of the afternoon. What you want to do is get up early. Get up early. And don't go and sit down for an hour in front of the iPad, the iPhone, the computer, or the TV to get the latest news. Good. Get up early and make a declaration. This is the day the Lord hath made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. So what I do every day is I awaken early and I say, this is the day the Lord hath made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is a gift from you to me, O Lord. Your mercies are renewed unto me this day. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord, unto me. And Marilyn and I place this day under your lordship. And may we embrace and experience all the potential and the possibilities of this brand new day. Then, why not get 5 minutes or 15 minutes at the most of news, so you can be alert, aware, and pray? You sit there for 30 minutes or more, there goes that whole, this is the day the Lord hath made. They're manipulating your mind. They are manipulating your mind. You're not going to have great faith if all you do is you sit back and listen to carnality. He is the prince and the power of the air. During the pandemic, when they had the death meter running, those news outlets made more money than they probably ever made in any other crisis. Right. And fear began to grip. Fear. Fear. I got news for you. If the Lord tarries, we're going to die. And you want me to tell you who just seconded that? About a month and a half ago, George and I are sitting in the den, and George, soon to be five, he said, Pops, one day we're all going to die. I said, yeah. Yeah, but George, let's change the topic, bro. I've got a few years on you, but we're going to. But we're acting like we're not going to. We're acting like this is a news bulletin. But 2,000 years ago, he came and took the sting out of death. March of 2020, the enemy put it back in, and we, some of us, succumbed to it. I don't mean death. I mean the fear. And I got news for you. They must be Nostradamus. They just told us there's another virus coming. They have no idea where it's going to come from. Not like they have dirty hands. Not like they're working in a lab somewhere. The WEF believes that we have an overpopulation problem of 1 billion people. Elon Musk ran the numbers 2 months ago, and he said, no, we don't. He said, we have to have more babies, because we'll never sustain human life if we don't have more babies. Maybe I should have emulated my father. I stopped that too. He had 19. They're messing with your mind. Can I tell you the dirty little secret? Any shortage is intentional. Any shortage is intentional. You know what the spirit of the age is saying? I'm going to be like the Most High. I'm going to take control, you puny little Christians. But maybe you want to take a hint. Because the enemy deemed it was going to be lights out beginning March of 2020 for Woodlawn. Well, the lights are burning brightly.
And then he said he was going to sink your boat financially, and even when you couldn't come to the house of God, your money did. Oh, those developers and inventors of social media platforms, they had no idea that you were going to send tithe and offerings. I wouldn't be surprised if you did not break a financial record right here in 2020. And then when I was here the last time physically, Pastor Jaron said, you know, maybe this would be a good morning to have another altar service. That's what he told me. And boy, did we have an altar service. And we're about to have one now. Because someone is standing back there. And you want the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And the enemy is saying, you're not good enough. Not going to happen to you. Why is he telling you that? If God is not intending to baptize you with the Holy Spirit today, why is the enemy telling you that? Why did you almost not make it here? What was that last minute thing that just came out of left field and boom, but you came? He's a loser. If you desire to be baptized with the Holy Spirit, you ought to leave where you're standing right now. Because you're going to have an experience with God that he can never have. This is your day. I'm serious. If you would like for me to lay hands on you and speak, be filled with the Holy Ghost today, this is your time to come. Oh, here they come. Here they come. Right around. Right around. How about in the risers? Anyone up there want to come down here and receive the Holy Ghost? Anyone in the risers? Anyone? 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 How about up in the balcony? Anyone want to come down and receive the Holy Ghost? Come on down. What's your first name?
Avian.
You were standing right behind me about four rows back when I was on the front. I don't know why the Lord told me this, but I'm supposed to tell you something. And if I miss it, I miss it. Because I don't operate on Facebook. If God gives me a word, it doesn't come from social media. And if you're using social media to get your prophetic words, shame on you. You're faking it till you make it. You better quit it. I took a look at you and the Lord said, tell him. He won't be afraid of the darkness. And it's not physical darkness. It's the darkness of this world. It has to do with your future. It has to do with the Lord just told me. It has to do with certain influences that you lack that should have built you up. And they should have been spiritual architects and said, you can do anything. But since that voice was not present, the darkness got on your mind, but you're going higher. You are going to it. You will not be mediocre. You will excel. You will excel. Whew. It changes today. Whoa! Now, these people are more my family than they are friends, and there's so many people that I've gotten to know through the years, but they should not miss out on a word because I know them. Nicole, would you raise your hands? You were standing right there in the worship service. And I did not see transfusion. As God is my witness, I saw infusion. I saw something just come into your body, infusion. It didn't use what was already in there to clean up with the transfusion. I saw an infusion. Live. Because it's Sunday. He's in your Monday. It's Sunday. He's in your Tuesday.
It's Sunday, he's in your Wednesday. And God's going to do really cool things with the three of you, and you're going to be right there to enjoy it. I decree it and I declare it. I will probably launch this Sunday this week as a quote, but I haven't wordsmithed it yet, but God gave it to me at the hotel this morning, and I'm supposed to share it with you. The Lord has told me to share with you that when things are fuzzy and blurry, your faith is going to keep you focused. You're going to be focused like a laser. And the two of you share talents, giftings that are similar. But at the same time, you have your differences that make the thing whole. But you're going to be the radar. You will feel it, you will see it, and you will know it. You will know what honors God, and you will know what attempts to dishonor God. And this day, I declare over you and the next generation, there shall be continuance. And there shall be increase. So where's your daughter, the singer? Is she in the building? Where's she at? Is that your daughter? How do I preach? Is that the preaching? Okay, don't preach because you're going to make me look bad. I'm not bringing you out here to preach, I'll tell you right now. But I have a word for you. How do I preach for so many years and look so young? Goodness sakes alive. Morton, I'm with a word. I had an unusual experience when I looked at you today. I'm a seer. What I see is brief. Am I taking too much time or can I minister a little bit longer? I got to drive 3.5 hours, but I'd like to hang with you for a few more minutes because you want the Holy Ghost. I looked at you. I know this sounds crazy. You turned into a printing press. God was putting data, words, and they were not just coming out in paper form. They were going out on social media and so forth. And you will also be present in person to deliver this. You, since a little girl, God has been building. Man, the Holy Ghost, this is so, the prophecy is so amazing how this happens to me. God has put a library in you since you were a little girl, and he's been stocking the shelves with tomes of wisdom that goes beyond your years. And as you wait upon God, your future has already been laid out. God has people, places, things all arranged, so you just go ahead and keep going straight, because I will tell you right now, this will be your base, at least for now. Doors are going to open for you. And stay close to the people that love you the most. Closest to the ones who love you the mostest. Because doors are going to open. Doors. And it will go beyond. I bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. When the lights are dimmed, and it's you, and the enemy seeks access into your mind, and he draws lines and he connects dots, and he talks about family history, and he talks about history with you and how this one left and so forth and so on. But in the name of Jesus Christ, you ask me to pray a couple of prayers. I do that every day without fail. I do it. So I'm not going to describe it because I already prayed for it. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, from the top of your head through your body to the soles of your feet, there'll never be a moment that he's not there.
And there'll never be a prayer he hasn't heard. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And there's going to be joy in the morning. There's going to be joy in the morning. Arabahu. If you have been diagnosed with Crohn's or diverticulitis or just something quite critical to the core of your body, the intestinal tract, the digestive tract, raise your hands up. Jesus is touching you now. You don't mind if I continue, do you? I'm supposed to speak to your blood. I know what I told you about this here, but I'm supposed to make a command, and it's to be the balance and the right ratio with white and red cells. I'm supposed to do that in Jesus' name. Now, Father, the situation we just prayed for, in the name of Jesus Christ, be loosed. Anyone else who has a similar situation, wave your hand so I can come to you. Raise your hands up. I see it on you right now. I see it on you right now. Here it comes. Urabaha. Would everybody praise God in the house? In the name of Jesus Christ. We're spreading fire around here today. We're spreading Holy Ghost fire around here today. Before I prayed for you, were you experiencing any pain or discomfort?
Not today.
You're not now. You're not the worse for the wear. You ready for Jesus to touch you? Your hands in the house. I'm going to make a command. One is to be healed. Father, one is complete liberty and freedom. No more bondage. No more strongholds of the enemy. It's over and done. Christ. Anyone else with this situation? You've been to the doctor with it?
What was that?
Have you been to the doctor with it?
Oh, yeah.
What have they said? Pain or discomfort right now? Really? So you have pain and discomfort right now? Over here. This seems to be a good spot right about here. If you're tired of standing, you won't offend me if you're seated. If you want to stand, stand. I'm going to pray for the Holy Ghost in just a second. How long have you had to put up with this?
Since 1985.
1985. That was 2 or 3 years before I showed up. Have I prayed for this before? About time. Would you raise your hands up? I'm supposed to tell you something else. Is that all right? You haven't mentioned this. From your hips to your toes, all the way down to the soles of your feet, literally from hips to toes, and every point in between, that would also be your knees.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, you know what?
what? When I just did that, said she's had some trauma right there, and I just correct. God said I just corrected it. That's your day. So whatever it was, whiplash, trauma of some kind, blunt force, whatever. Whoa! He's in this house. He's in this house. So since 1985, I believe you heard the prayer, do you?
Yes.
You do?
Absolutely.
Come here. Get over here. We're going to do a little uphill. Turn around, please. Come. How you feeling now?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Say it again just like you did.
Oh, my God.
Say it again just like you did.
Oh, my God.
Because someone around here needs to get healed right around here. Someone around here needs to hear a lady say, oh, my God, because it's not being vulgar. It's not. It's taking anything in vain. She's saying, oh, my God, because she's healed. And whatever you need healing of, receive it right now. Whatever you might need healing of, be healed right now in the name of Jesus. Everybody praise you. Praise him. Okay, I believe it's established. So anyone that has a stomach condition, raise your hands up. In the name of Jesus Christ, by the authority of the Word of God, I command that out of your body right now. Is you? Who do you want me to pray for? What's the name? From head to toe, be healed. I speak healing over you right now in Jesus' name. So we have several that have come down to receive the Holy Ghost. You that have come down to receive the Holy Ghost, would you congregate right here? Come right here. Have I prayed for you before?
No, sir.
You repented?
Yes, sir.
You've given your heart to Jesus? At the hotel, the Lord reminded me if they need to repent, that repent, but you're going to pray for people that have been on the way for a while. They repented. What's your first name?
Clay.
Clay, I've been around this for 40 years. It's on you right now. In this building out. You're in his presence. It's yours for the asking because it's there right now. It's there. Oh, come on, everybody, praise him in the house. Praise him. When I speak a word of prophecy or knowledge, Clay, I just do it by faith. It's on you right now, so you just shut yourself in because I don't care how many syllables it is. It's you and him right now. It's you and him right now. Why don't you raise your, have you given your heart to Jesus? Everybody praise him in the house. Praise him in the house. Everybody, do it again. Again, la, 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 do it again, la, la, ha, shakata, do it again, Clay, la, 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 ya, la, 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 do it again, Clay, la, la, ha, ya, la, 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 yes, do it again, Clay, yes. Yes, from the top of your head, through your body, to the soles of your feet, who wants the Holy Ghost? Have you given your heart to Jesus? You have? Both of you want the Holy Ghost? Have you given your heart to Jesus? You've repented of your sins? Am I missing anybody? Have you given your heart to Jesus? You want the Holy Ghost? You want the Holy Ghost? There ought to be a bunch of you down here. Say, Lord Jesus, wash me in your blood and cleanse me. Keep them up because here comes the Holy Ghost upon you. Raise your hands. It's on you now. You know what? I'm supposed to tell you something. The Lord kept you. And he kept things from you, and he kept you from things. And I believe he kept you alive for some. I don't know what it was, but God kept you alive for this moment. The enemy didn't want it to happen, but he's already lost because you're here. You're standing here today, and the power of God's upon you. And just like it came upon Clay, it's on you right now, so you begin to praise him. That's it. Here it comes. Here it comes. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again right out of tongues. That just like you were doing. Everybody praise him in the house. Do it again. Do it again. Do it some more. Do it some more. Put your hand right here. Put your hand right here. Don't be afraid of it. Praise him and lift him up. It's on you right now. I just saw it. Do it again. I just saw it come upon you. Do it again. Do it some more. Do it. That's it. That's it. That's it. You're beautiful. You're a handsome man. You're a beautiful young lady. Holy Ghost, come upon them. These are yours, Jesus. Fill them, I pray. I want some of you to come help me pray. Some of you come here. I need some young men right here. Come help me pray. You, right over here, right over here, right over here. You come for the Holy Ghost. You're giving your heart to Jesus. What's your first name? It's on you right now, Jaden. Do it again, Jaden. Jaden, do it again. Do it. Yes, do it, do it, do it. It's on you right now. Do it again. Do it again. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God. There is something different in here than that is in this world.
Yes, Lord.
There is something in here that is so different than is in this world. It's powerful. It's powerful. Holy Ghost, come upon this dear woman right here, right now. In Jesus' name. Everybody praise him. Everybody praise him. A seer. My grandson likes to play with Lego and tracks. Don't play with all the train tracks. Don't make a train track. I just saw a train track being fitted back together. The journey is going to become the other for people. There's a future in the future. Top of your head to the soles of your feet, be healed right now in Jesus' name. I speak it.
Name no grave could ever hold.
There's so many people in this house today that need a miracle. And if you have faith to believe today for the miracle that you need for your life, I want you to get out of your seat. Maybe you're already here, but I want you to make your way to this altar today. I want you to take a step of faith. And I'm going to ask Brother Bustard to come back. And he's going to pray a prayer of faith. But I want you to take a step believing today. I'm going to give you time. Just gather around the front. Most of you are already here. Others are coming right now in the name of Jesus.
Would you raise your hands to the heavens? Father, heaven has come down to earth. The last few weeks have been absolutely amazing because you increase and I decrease. Your power comes in, my power is not even needed. I'm not going to pretend that I have anything to do with the healing. The Lord wants me to tell you, he is putting a shield of, look at me, he wants me to tell you, he's putting a shield of protection around you and your family. And the things that would try to reach are not going to be successful because God has lifted your family up. And I said that in a way that's a parable, but you get the message. You get the message in Jesus. You get the message. Okay, raise your hands up from the top of your head through your body to the soles of your feet, to your blood sugar that is unbalanced, to kidneys that are not at 100%, to blockages in main arteries, to bones that have become brittle, to minds that know no peace, to bodies that know no rest, I speak healing. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Be healed. Father, anyone here is carrying a load because of lack of finances, I bless them. Because you are going to absorb inflation, it will not absorb you. And you are going to feast in a famine. And if inflation tries to turn off the spigot of finances, God's going to carve another river of revenue into your life, and it's going to come from different places. Don't worry, God has more river. He had four in the Garden of Eden, the Hiddekel, Pies, and Guys, and the Euphrates. God can put a river anywhere of revenue to bless you and your family. And I'm telling you right now, you will not live content to have the deed, no debt. You will not just look to create it. God will expand your vision. And through your very genteel, easy peasy way, easy like Sunday morning, you're going to bless. And you will see this congregation rise up. How many feels that God has laid his hand upon you to bless you so you can be a blessing to his kingdom, and that would include finances? In the name of Jesus. Raise him back up. I saw a layer, and then I saw another layer being put on that. Double. Whatever that number was, you were delayed, not denied, because God said, if you'll let me, I'm going to do something really good. And I'm telling you, in Jesus' name. I bless your homes in the name of Jesus. I pray for revival in your homes. I pray for revival among your sons and daughters, your grandchildren. This is what it's all about. I'm telling you right now, he's doing everything in his power to keep the kids from prophesying, because it's the end time. In the last days, your sons and daughters will prophesy. He's trying to wipe them out because they're going to be prophets. The shelter in place, the two-year hiatus, they say is going to have a psychological effect upon your children, not around here. They are saying that kids are going to be at least 2 years behind in education, not around here. They are saying that kids are going to have a psychosis and neurosis and phobias and fears. It's not going to happen around here, because we raise champions around here. I bless your children in the name of Jesus. I ask God to liberate them and anoint them in the name of Jesus. I call upon the young generation to rise up and prophesy in this house. I prophesy that this will be the generation that will bring down a giant. And the world will not know what... Oh, forgive me. I sent out a quote the other day, and maybe if you understand biology, you'll get it. Somewhere along the line, a man and a woman met. And then they engaged. And then they engaged. And then they consummated, and something happened at some point. And there were 300 million swimming to cross the line. 200 of these swimmers crossed the line, but only one met the woman's egg, and you're here. And I'm telling you, Elijah and Moses may return in the end time briefly for a couple days, but the Apostle Paul and Peter are not coming back, because God did not make a mistake when you were among 300 million contestants and 200 made it in, but you were the one that lived. Your life is a miracle, not a mistake. God could have put you 2,000 years in the past. He put you right here. I call upon you to rise up and prophesy. I call upon this church to be leading in the fivefold ministry and the nine gifts of the Spirit. My apologies. Give the Lord a big hand clap.
Amen. If you came here for a miracle, just lift your hand. He's already spoke the word of faith. Would you place your hand on somebody that has their hand up right now? We're about to pray in faith together as a church and just thank him for the miracle. I want you to speak it out and prophesy over their life right now in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Come on, I want you to speak it and prophesy over their life right now. You have faith in you to believe today. And you have power to prophesy in the name of Jesus.
Change. I pray that the circumstances would change. I pray that the fear inside would flee in Jesus' name. I pray that a breakthrough would happen today. I pray miracles over your life in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.